In this tutorial, we will see that how can we insert various types of fitting of various tiles to different types of piping in Autodesk Inventor. First of all, I will explain that from where these fitting can be accessed. One source of it is that is inbuilt Inventor Content Center or Inventor Library. Here we have opened a previously modeled piping system from 3D Sketch, as I explained in a previous tutorial for Autodesk Inventor. Let me place fitting from Content Center or Inventor Library. For that, we will go to Assembly and in the place from the Content Center or Importer Files, here the various options. Let we go to the Inventor Center. Here we have various types of parts, 3D parts, standard 3D parts, and here we can see that a tube and pipe sections. When we expand, we can see that conduits and fittings. And we will go to the fitting tabs. We can see that various types of piping fitting, adapters, branches, bushings, caps, connectors, couplings, crosses, elbows, and lot of modes from the top to bottoms. Let we insert some type of flange to our piping systems. Here we can see that a lot of different types of standard flanges, and let we insert a threaded flange because our piping system is threaded one. It is our own requirement, temperature, pressure ratings, and stress phenomena in the piping system. These will be selected according to all these factors contributing to overall piping design systems. Because our piping system has a half inch diameter, we can take it as a custom or as a standard. As a custom, we can rename and save and selected fittings, and here we have to go back. Let we do not save it and take it as a standard. And go to the pipe run again. Route 101, and we have back to the tube and pipe run. Here we can see that connect fitting tab, and when we put our cursor on the given fitting, we can see that it is pointing in direction. We will select it and then the piping system, and we can see that here is the engagement standards. We can select standard engagement and route 01 and users defined. In users defined arrangement, we can see that we can change it up to any range that we insert 0.03 and apply. Okay, we can see that insertion of flange has been take place, but not to all the threads because we have reduced the engagement range or size. In this way, we can insert other types of fittings. Let we insert some type of elbow. Here we have elbow of various spec and sizes. Let me insert ANSI, ASM, ASME. Let sizes of the fitting are 1/2 inch. Here's our elbow. Let we put it into the second end of the pipe. For that we have to go into the route 01 and run 01 and place fitting, not a connect fitting. We have already placed the fitting. Let we connect this end to this end of piping. And we take it as standard engagement 0.530. You can see that elbow has been placed and all the threads has been covered by the elbow. After insertion of the fitting in the piping system, we can change the orientation of the fitting according to our operational requirement and plant layout. We can also change the size of the fitting that we change it to 3/4 inch. But here we can see that it has been changed to a larger one, and we can reverse it. We can also replace the existing fitting from a new one to other spec. Let we change it to a 45 degree elbow. But the orientation will not be maintained, and we can readjust the orientation. In this way, we can insert fitting in the Autodesk Inventor in our piping system, and we can make several changes as I have discussed. Similarly, we can insert other types of fitting from the Inventor content center. And the other thing is, if we not find any type of fitting in this library or content center of the Inventor, we can model in any CAD software or even Inventor, and we can put it into Inventor library, and we can import spec of various styles that is not available in Inventor library from the other CAD software like AutoCAD Plan 3D and other plan design software available in the market.